Good morning, folks, and what a morning it is. Fantastic weather, not too cold, yeah, a bit windy. Brought the dog along to do some wildlife tracking. So, in today's session, folks, we are going to be having a bit of a scout around in the forests to look for tracks and signs, anything really. Just been a squirrel run up there, first mammal of the day. You know, looking around these woodlands, seeing what we can find, showing you how to measure a few tracks, stuff like that, you know. And these videos, you know, bit of fun. People will pick up a few things along the way and we'll get you out into wildlife tracking, give you the means, you know, to get you out there and enjoy Britain's green spaces. And this is a fantastic place to start because it's pretty accessible for anyone that lives near me. You know, it's one of the smallest, well, probably is the smallest area of outstanding natural beauty in the UK. And oh my days, it actually is a beautiful place. Come down, have a look, see what you can find. Now we're going to get into some bit more serious wildlife tracking. We're going to find you some tracks, show you how to measure them, talk you through the field guides, an essential carry kit, and a bit about the substrates. Keep watching, folks. When you're wildlife tracking, substrate, which is what's on the ground, is one of the most important things to have a look at. Tracks can, you know, when an animal leaves a track, it can do it in numerous different ways over numerous different substrates. So for instance, we're walking in an old forestry trail made by some very, very big forestry machinery, and this stuff is perfect because it's quite wet, stays wet, especially being in these big pine woodlands, very damp. So it means anything that walks across, there's a good chance it's going to leave you a track. Other substrates to consider: wet sand, that's a cracking one. Wet mud, and you know, just have a look genuinely everywhere, you know, because even on tarmac animals can leave a track. If they've walked through a puddle and you're quick enough to find it, they can leave you a wet outline, like a wet print on the tarmac that you can physically have a look at and have a gander. Yeah, what are you drinking that for? That's disgusting. Yeah. So as you can see, very wet, very muddy, perfect to find us some tracks. So folks, just stopped for a little breather because I am knackered. Just to briefly talk about your field guides and how to measure a track. We will find some more tracks later on. So I just thought I'd roughly and very quickly talk you through what these two are for. So this is the Whaling Field Guide to the Tracks of West European Animals. Very good, recently been published. They are fantastic trackers at Whaling. Brilliant trackers everywhere. They do a lot in Europe, so check them out, we're on Facebook. And basically, these books are fantastic at telling you the differences between tracks. So, you know, we're comparing like dogs, domestic cats, to wolves and jackals, and foxes, which is very, very, very important. But we'll come into this at a later video for you all. But basically, this gives you the real life sizes of these tracks. So, as you can see, you know, it gives you the real life size of a fox track right there. And if you just skip through, you know, you've got all your deer. We'll probably come across a few of these tracks today. So these are fallow deer, and they are everywhere. May, if we're lucky enough, come across some roe deer, fingers crossed. And this just gives you the real life sizes of them all. Few facts, the gait here, so how they walk, you know, whether it's walking or the running or the striding. And it's just full of fantastic tracks, everything from voles, mice, even just reptiles in the back. Fantastic guide. Cannot tell you enough, folks, to get yourself a decent tracking guide. It is the tracker's Bible. Anywho, and it's fell on the floor. Fab. Now we come up to this lovely piece of equipment. So this is a ruler. Very simple. Doesn't take a genius to work one of these, but it is essential for tracking. So what we do with these is we place these on the floor near the track, so your track will be there. Place these on the floor, and then jobs are good. You have the length and you have the width of the track. It's that simple. But some tracks can look very similar, so without one of these, it's very, very, very hard to distinguish the difference in tracks. So very, 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 very essential to carry one of these, folks. And we're going to show you how to use this later on in the video when we come across some decent examples that you can actually see on the GoPro of how to measure a track. So now we're going to crack on right through this woodland. We're just going to push through and see what we can find in the glorious, glorious weather that has been given to us today. So what we're going to do, folks, just found this very, 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 very thin trail, which the dog is now standing on, of, you know, it's basically an animal pathway. It's like an animal motorway, basically, or a highway if you're watching in the US of A. And basically, animals create these by regularly running up and down. It's like a favoured route, like the route you'd take to work, basically. So we're just going to follow this, see what we can see, see what we can find. The dog's already one step ahead of me by legging it. So yeah, we're gonna go through. Keep your eyes on the floor, but remember to look up, because you don't want to bang your head. Ow! Like that. Oh my god. So we're just going to push through and see what we can see. The wind is a bit bad today, but it is coming right towards us, which is good, because that means the animals won't smell us if we're heading in this direction, because their scent is coming towards us. So yeah, let's hit this trek and see what we can find. Gonna find us some deer tracks. Gonna see where they go. At the moment, there's none. Oh my days, that sun's bright. It is a glorious day, folks, for a February. Climate change is happening as we speak. So, folks, we have found some tracks. Jobs are good. I apologise about the wind in advance, because as you can see, we are in a very, very, very open landscape. So, just to show you these tracks here, this is exactly how you'd use the ruler. So, as you can see, here's the tracks here. This is actually a double imprint, so there's two. So you can see the first track here and the edge of the second track there. So ignoring the second track for the time being, because we'll come to that at a later video. As you can see, the first track, you're taking it from 1 centimeter there, taking it right the way back down. It ends at around about 8. So you can see it ends about here. Always have brought your guidebook handy. So as you can see, this is fallow deer, because you can have a look at the size, you can see the shape, and you know, just compare it, take a moment, you know, don't rush into it, have a think about what, you know, the landscape, think about the deer or even the animal, you know, that's in the area, for example. You know, take a moment, just sit, have a look, look at it from all different angles, because sometimes on a sunny day it can cast shadows and then it looks a bit distorted. So yeah, just take the time, have a read through, you know, and the benefit of that is calms you down, you're sitting in nature for a bit, and of course you get to see other animals while you're sitting and quietly looking at the tracks. For example, just been sitting here for a few minutes while I've been setting up the camera, and there's already been a buzzard flying over there, had a few squirrels bouncing around doing the thing, and of course the dog is loving life, running through all the wilderness. So yeah, that's how you use a ruler. Keep your guidebook handy. Few simple tips that will help you on the way to be a successful animal tracker. And of course folks, the only way to do this is to get out there, grab your book, grab your backpack, grab your dog if you really want to, they'll definitely appreciate it, grab your ruler, head out there and have a look and get searching. Just to round off the video, hopefully it's shown you enough to get out there, look for tracks and signs. Again, don't forget your guidebooks, don't forget your ruler, carry your first aid kit, some water. And another thing I forgot to mention, it's very important to carry something like binoculars or a long range camera. Because then, if you've got your binoculars, you can see the animals, whereas if you've got your camera, you can zoom in, see what animals, you know, you've got out and about. And if you do a successful track, so what I mean by that is, if you were to head down this track, for example, and you were following some relatively fresh deer tracks, and then you come across the animal, you can then photograph and document that journey right the way through to the end, which is what we call a successful track. And just to end on some high notes, here's some more deer tracks I know just from basic knowledge of the area, and I've been tracking for a good few years, that these are all fallow deer heading up this forestry path. So it just goes to show folks that it's very, very, very important to check out these forestry paths that different organizations or logging companies have made. They are vital for the movement of large ungulates such as deer. So yeah, just to round off folks, hope that's been enough for you. It has been an absolute pleasure doing this video for you. So get out there folks, grab your kit and find us some tracks.